Joseph, favored son of Israel.
The road to Emmaus. On the third day after Jesus' crucifixion, two of his disciples were going to the village of Emmaus. While they walked and questioned each other, Jesus himself came near and walked with them, but their eyes were kept from recognizing him.
What are we going to do now?
I thought he was the one. Why are you walking and talking so sadly?
Don't you know the things that have happened recently in Jerusalem?
What things? The things concerning the prophet, Jesus the Nazarene. The priests and our rulers crucified him.
But we were hoping that he would redeem Israel.
And now it is the third day since these things happened.
Also, some of the women from our group said that he was alive.
Foolish people.
Didn't the prophets write that the Son of Man had to suffer these things in order to enter into his glory?
Beginning from the law and the prophets, he explained to them in all the scriptures the things concerning himself. This is just one of the stories Jesus could have told.
Consider the story of
Joseph!
Greetings, Bible nerds. It is I, Artsy Bible Nerd. Here it goes. Phew, scared me for a little bit. When last we left our fated hero, we were on page 13. We had started this drawing, but we had also wanted to, Hold on here. Let's go find recently. Here we go. That's the one. Open that. Take two. When last we left our biblical hero, Joseph, he was sitting around the fire talking to his family about the second dream that he had, and everyone has been fully drawn. All we need is some background. We have heads and shoulders and clothing and on this panel as well. So now, what should be in the background? They were shepherds, so we will be drawing some sheep. Thank you very much. 1930s announcer with your vibrato voice. I don't know why that went out of style. So yes, hi. It's been a long time. I took a week off. Apparently my body needed the week off. Because one day I came downstream and my body rebelled. And said, nope, you're going to sleep now. So, 1 week later, I started streaming again. So, you know, it's not as dramatic as a story that you'd want to hear on a streamer's page, but that's how it happened. So, sorry that I didn't give any notice. So we're going to draw some sheep. Undo. We're going to put that on another layer. It's been so long I can't remember how to add another layer. And then we're going to make it blue. I said blue. There we go. So, you would think that I had done my research before now, before showing up on the stream that I had expected to be at, but no. I'm going to look for some references for sheep. Not just any sheep, but
sheep of the region. So I'm searching for sheep from Hebron. Looking for some images. I took a picture of some local sheep, but that's probably not the sheep that we're looking for. Also, when I drove up with my car to the sheep field, this field where all the sheep were grazing casually, as soon as they saw me get out of the car, they stopped and posed for the picture, like looked straight at me, gathered in a group as if they had done this before. I was like, no, I don't want you in a posed picture. I just want you to be candid. This is not how sheep actually act. Be yourselves, sheep. So they did not be their sheepy selves. They were not their sheepish selves. So I'm looking for a flock of sheep from Hebron. All right, I think I found something. I have found what I'm looking for. That did not take as long as I expected it to take. I believe these are the sheep that I'm looking for. Eventually, because my computer is blazing fast, I have so much RAM, I don't know what to do with it. I have so much processor speed. Okay, here we go. Let's put it, I don't know where to put it. Let's put it on the desktop. And we'll call it Sheep from Hebron. Because I'm so creative. That's such a creative name. And now we're going to transfer it from the desktop to the iPad. We are transferring. We are waiting for the send to actually happen.
And there it is. So now we copy the photo, and we take it to, paste. I didn't expect that photo to show up, actually, because it's a copyrighted image, so. Where did it go? Why did it not paste? I said copy, right? Copy photo. And now we're going to paste the already copied photo. Oh, you know what? It's probably right behind. No, it's not. Here, sheepy, 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 sheepy. All right, this is not what I wanted to do on stream. I didn't expect to be doing this while people were watching, quote unquote watching. Let's open with a different. Okay. You know what? I think what we need to do is find another photo, because this is formatted in a way that I don't want it to be formatted. I think these sheep will do. These sheep will do very nicely. Let's open it in Photoshop. Oh, and by the way, for those of you who don't know that I'm a baseball fan, and for those of you who don't know that I live in Pennsylvania, I'm very happy that the Phillies are going to the World Series. Are they going to win the World Series? That remains to be seen. I did not expect them to get as far as they did. I did not expect them to get past round one with the Cardinals. But I am pleasantly surprised. I am very happy to be wrong about my prediction. All right, we're dealing with technical difficulties here. Dealing with technical. Things. While we're doing that, let's zoom in. All right, this one is a JPEG. This one should work. The previous one was a WebP. I don't know what that stands for. WebP? Web photo, maybe? Give me an old-fashioned JPEG, right? I know what that's... Well, maybe I don't know what it stands for, but I know what it does. Jackson Hole Photography's group, I think it stands for. Because these people met at Jackson Hole when they created the JPEG format. I am eating. Okay, you know what? Wouldn't you like to watch something more interesting? How much more interesting can we get? Can we make this? Let's give you one of these. Okay, that's better. That is better. That's what we want. Let's turn the music back up. All right, now, I'm just going to go I'm not going to trace exactly what I see. It's going to be hard not to trace exactly what I see. This is why I don't like tracing photos. So I don't want this dark area to get too close to the other dark area, so I lose the outline of her face, of her head there. And I can't forget, that it is dark outside. So I'm going to make this sheep look dark on the top because the light from the fire is coming at its face. All right, what happened to my... Here we go. Show me... It's like I've never used this computer before. Here we go. All right, this is what I want to see. Now, instead of tracing, I'm referencing from... from the big screen onto the small screen where I'm drawing. So I think I'm going to get a better... Let's hope that we're going to get a better result this way instead of straight up tracing. So, let's do it like this. These sheep have floppy ears, like dogs, like Snoopy ears. So I have to remember where the lighting comes from. I have to keep reminding myself of that. If you're tired of me saying that, I'm sorry to hear that. So what I really want to happen, is I would love to challenge a streamer from Houston who's a Houston Astros fan and get some kind of humiliation bet going. But it's very hard for me to find anybody who's into sports on Twitch. What is up with that? Am I such an old man?
Nobody cares about sports anymore.
All right, let's draw the next sheep. Back in my day, every Saturday the sports would be on. We used to watch a program called ABC's Wide World of Sports. Gone are the days. Gone are the days when everyone had a favorite sport. This does not look like a convincing sheep here. Some of these sheep looks like they're wearing a vest. Looks like they're wearing a sleeves on top. Just a little too big. Not only too big, but I think it's just not straight. This one's starting to look like an ostrich. I don't want that to happen. I'm not well versed in sheep anatomy. Have not drawn enough sheep to do this without looking. There's that jacket or vest I was talking about. Let's flip this horizontal, vertical. I think horizontal. Yes, there we go. Now, yes, I like that. Let's drag this one over. All right, let's sell the illusion. We're gonna erase the parts where these bodies intersect. Let's continue this drawing of this sheep. We're gonna sell the illusion, selling the drama, selling this illusion. Let's finish this guy's head up here. That's what they're saying. Okay, we need more sheep on the left-hand side. Tell you what, let's start over here. Start over here. Sheep are funny looking animals. Sheep are funny looking. When you look at their bone structure, that's a nice leg of lamb. They're not as fluffy as I would have thought. It's more like hairs, more like, like matted hair that has not been washed. Wow, those legs are too long. That's starting to look like a horse. Let's calm that down. Calm down, Trigger. Now it just looks like a little horse. Shetland pony. That is not what it's supposed to look like. Let's cut these legs down. Pretty sure you had to be extremely rich to afford a horse back then. Maybe it's the neck. That's the problem. The neck is too long. The neck and the legs were too long. That's what makes a horse. So, today, tomorrow rather, is the office Halloween party.
I tried on... So I've been collecting these pieces for a Sam Wilson concert costume, rather. And that's not the way to do it. That is not the way that you do cosplay. If you want to be effective at it, that's not the way you do it. I've come to realize that buying stuff piecemeal from different suppliers, different sellers, is not the way to make a convincing... I've lost the lid to my snack, and if I don't have a lid on it, I'm gonna get ants. That's how you get ants. Ah, found it. That's better. Now I feel better. All right, that's better looking. Those legs are looking stubbier. A lot less horse-like than it was previously. That's what we're going for. Let's have a head sticking out here. One good thing about having a whole flock of sheep is not only can I look at individual heads and draw them, but I have so many varieties of ears at my disposal that I'm looking at here. So I took an ear from one head and just drew it onto a different head than I was drawing before. So that way it doesn't seem like it's such a repetitive, the same sheep after another, like it's a mechanical copy and paste situation. Okay, so that's the background sheep. Well, in one layer, that's the foreground sheep.
Thank you.
All right, so now, what am I going to do next? Let's do the same thing I did before. Let's copy and paste this layer. And let's flip it. Nope, that's not what I wanted. Undo. I want it to be flip horizontal. That's it. And now move it. Looking for the place that's going to look most believable. I do not like that sheep over there. I do not like that being exactly where that is. Oh, D. Raven! Draven 1187, how are you? Good to see you, welcome in. Let's give you a shout out. How's everything going? Have you been? So, as I was saying, I think this has to go. this one on the fringe. I think I'm going to let him go. Thank you very much. We'll let you know. Alright, so now, are we ready to ink? Let's find out if we're ready to ink. Let's use the brush. To keep remembering, remind myself where the light is coming from. Stop me if you've heard this before. I'm kidding, you can't stop me. Make it darker back here. I don't think I have the right stroke. I don't think it's very looking very sheep-like. Not looking very sheepish. All right, everyone.
I'm going to cut it short tonight. For those of you watching in the future, I will be here tomorrow night, which is Wednesday night. Yeah, Wednesday night at 10 p.m. in order to continue drawing more sheep. And until then, may the Lord be with you. Peace.